So the last class we had started with the third unit, which was completely business intelligence component framework here. So just I'll go back again for your revise here. What was that here? The business intelligence component framework. I'm audible to you. Anyone respond me? At least message me. I'm audible to your what?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Business intelligence component framework, it is divided into three layers. Why it is used for the purpose of getting successful, how it will get successful here. There are three things are there, which is a technical, functional, and financial also it will work here, okay? Technical is there, functional is there, and the data need of the enterprise is here. Whatever these are there, that's for the reason your business or organization is getting completely successful, okay? And there are three layers. Those are business layer, administration and operation layer, implementation layer here. If you follow these layers here, step by step it is there here. So let me give it a glance again for your diagram. So three layers are there. The yellow color represents completely business layer. The green, it is what administration and operation layer, and the last one it is the implementation layer. Okay, so one by one again, your first layer of the business intelligence component framework consists of this one business layer of four layers, in that you have business requirements, value, and program management and development here. Four things are there here. Your first layer of your BI component framework has four layers again, or four categories. Those are business requirements, business value, program management, and development care. Okay, so let us see once again. In the business requirements, before starting your business or before starting your organization, you are supposed to decide, or otherwise assume that you have already business. You want to make some changes. To make that changes, someone should lead. Someone should take initiate that we want to change the rule like this. So again, in the business requirements, you have three categories. Those are business drivers, business goals, and business strategies. And in your business driver, someone has to take initiative to change something. Already it is running, but थोड़ा तो कुछ तो आपको change करना है. कोई तो आगे आकर बात करना चाहिए कि हम ये change करेंगे. Okay. Then business goals here. Whatever you have decided to make the changes, you are supposed to plan for that. How the changes can be made. So these are the targets to be achieved in response to the business drivers. What you have decided to make change, here you are supposed to decide who will take care of that. How are you going to change? Example, I have given the best example. It is what? From the cash to the cash transaction payment to the cashless transactions here. If you have decided to change the payment mode system in your business drivers, then in the business course, you have to start working on that. Means what kind of a payment you have to do. You have to go either for the debit, or that is for the business goals. And then business strategies are the plan course of action that will help to achieve the set goals here. Means what you have decided, assume you have decided to make the target for the cash payment, it is debit and credit card. So for that purpose, what you need? You need a swiping machine. And if people are going to work for the GPA or PhonePe, you need the QR scan code. That is there, okay? So these are the three layers of your business requirement. That is business driver, goals, and strategies. And in your business value, it is completely related to your commerce part where accountancy will be there. So again, in the business value, whatever your business is there, is there any problem? Anyone is talking? Let me see whose mic it is. Okay, Pavitra. Pavitra, I think... Just a minute. Okay. Yes, she was not from the 6th sem. By mistake, she might have come for your 4th, 6th sem. In the business value, we have to concentrate on what you have invested, what kind of a business it is there here. Are you people getting profit or no? That it is there. Again, what? Okay. So whether your business is getting this what increased or no, or you are having facing some loss here. So there are the four categories out there for your business value. The first one, it is a return on investment. Then second one, it is what return on assets. And the third one, total cost of ownership and the total value of ownership here. So here yesterday I had given the examples like a return on investment. It is that your current business is running, but still you want to make more business, more profit is there. So what you can do, it is for that, you can take a help of social media like a Facebook or Twitter or Instagram. There you can start making your advertisement, and with the help of that, you are profit is getting more and increased here, where you were used to earn 5% here. But after using your social media, you have started earning 10% more here. Then your return on asset is what? How much you are earning, how much you have invested, and how much you people are earning here. So what is your own amount here? And the total cost of ownership, it is, example, it is what? Purchase of bullet bike. Last class I had given the example for the Ajay. Ajay is deciding to take a bullet bike here, which is of 2 lakhs. The moment he will purchase a bullet of 2 lakhs, after that we are supposed to put some petrol, then give some charges for maintenance. Everything is there. But so 2 lakh plus maintenance here or whatever the this what silly cost will be there. So that total amount, it is what called as a total cost of ownership here. And the total value of ownership means what? If Ajay has decided to sell his bullet bike, what value he will get here? So that is also there. Okay. Means what? He has decided to sell his bullet bike for 1,50,000. 6 महीने के बाद बस इतना ही चलेगा ना. If it is of 10 years, means he can sell it for 80,000. I am not aware that completely how much amount you can spend here. So if he has decided to sell after 6 months, so he can do it for 1,50,000 here. So now that 1,50,000 total value of ownership, what will be there? He has decided to take another bullet bike here. What value he can provide here? So 1,50,000. Upon that, again, what amount he has to put? Okay, suppose which he has decided to take again 3 lakh bike here, Rajendra. So 1 lakh again he has to put extra things here. So that is what the total value of ownership here. So this is the business value. Then next third one of your third category of your business layer is program management. Then in your, you have decided to start your business or already it is there. So what all you can manage in your program here, okay? It ensures that the people here in this program management category, it ensures that the people, projects and priority work in a manner in which individual processes are compatible with each other as to ensure seamless integration and smooth functioning of the entire program. So here three things are there, three terms are there, or three ingredients are there: people, project, and priorities. Here together you are supposed to work, no? Work. You have to decide how many employees are going to take in your company, then what kind of a projects are there, and the priority also matters here. So for which project you have to give the priority, or for which people you have to give the priority, what task it is there, what priority you can give here, to whom you are supposed to allocate the project, and which project you are going to manage. So let us see here why it is required, people, project, and priorities. Because whatever your business is there, it should work smooth function here. Smoothly it should work here. There should not be any flaws or errors here. So that's what the reason people, project, and priorities are the important here. So again, in this different types of things are there where you are supposed to check business priorities. What kind of a business is that? How much priorities you have to give for which client or for which customer? Then second part, it is what mission and goals you get of your organization or for your business. What is your mission and what is your goal here? Strategies and risk also here. Business aa gaya matlab risk bhi aayega na. थोड़ा तो झगड़ा करना ही पड़ेगा. रिस्क यू आर सपोज टू टेक हियर. ओके, देन मल्टीपल प्रोजेक्ट्स हियर. इफ योर कंपनी इज ऑफ कंप्लीटली टेक्निकल हियर, लाइक कंप्यूटर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज देयर और वेबसाइट डेवलपमेंट इज देयर हियर और एनी काइंड हियर, यू कैन टेक एग्जांपल ऑफ दिस वर्ड इंजीनियर आल्सो, सिविल इंजीनियर. सो ही और शी हैज टू have the ability to take the multiple project. It doesn't mean that hey, me project ghetlela ahe ata mala hi sampaycha ahe, then only I can work for the second. No, you have to work simultaneously. That is what the reason you people have main three ingredients: people, project, priority. Here you cannot say that I have only one project, I have currently my project is going on and I have to complete that, then I can take your project there. No, you cannot do that here. So that is what the multiple project should also be there here. Dependencies, of course, people matlab dependency aayega hi na. If there are no people, your project will not work nor your program will work here. So dependencies is required. So it is the main part that you are supposed to cooperate with your co-workers or workers here. Then cost and value, of course, because whenever you're going to start the project here, cost is also required and what value is also required. If you're going to develop a website here and supposed to sell that website, whatever that you're going to give, what amount you're going to take that and what is the value of it? How much amount you have put the efforts and what value you're getting? Return on investment here. Then what are the business rules here? Now your guidelines are going on under the resort lockdown here. So the rules are of what? It should be open from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. After that, there are. So according your business or organization also, there are the kind of rules here. What rules can be followed here? Normal rules here. Normal, we will say no, the cake order also you are supposed to give 8 hours previous. These all things are there. So to start developing the website also, some rules will be there. You have to decide whether you want to accept the project or no. Here the payment should be done here. So this is an infrastructure. Yes, agar aap business start karna chahte ho ya organization mein ya company hai, so infrastructure to aayega. So for that infrastructure also you are supposed to give some amount. Maintenance is required. If you are business of completely this what cyber cafe, so for that you need computer system is required, table is required, internet is required. For that what all amount you are going to spend, so that will come under the program management here. So that is what the reason three ingredients are there: people, project and priorities. Okay, so this is the program management, and the last one, it is what development here. Once your business is ready, what development you can do here? Yes, it consists of the database or data warehouse development consisting of completely ETL, which is extraction transformation loading. Aapka business already hai aur wahan pe jo bhi data hai, whatever the data is available here, to access that data you are supposed to follow the three things, that is ETL here, which is called as extraction, transformation and loading here. Okay. And data profiling is there, data cleansing is there, and database tools. Then second point specifies that data integration system development here, which was consisting of all the integration tools and data quality tools here. So integration means what heterogeneous sources will be there. You are supposed to integrate that together. Now you are currently, your project people are working. No, we will say that admin module, customer module, otherwise college module here. So that's all the modules should be there in one common website, right? So when you are combining together, so that time you will say that integration here. So for that, what tools are there? How you can manage in your development purpose? And the last one, it is what business analytics development here. It is completely about the processes and various technologies used here. How we are going to analyze here and to integrate all the data here. What all process you have followed here? Like what kind of a database storing you have used? Either NoSQL or MySQL, or what kind of a database server you people are using to store the data here and to analyze the data. Then this is your the last part of business layer, that is a development. Three things we have completed. First, it was a business requirement. Under the business requirements, you have three things, that is a business drivers, business goals and business strategies. Second type, it is what the business value. Again, it has a four categories: ROA, ROI, which is a return on investment. You can give the Facebook, Twitter example. Return on asset here, how much amount you are earning from your business, and the total cost of ownership, which means from purchasing time of purchase here and to till you leave, till you sell that bike, anything here. Okay, so So that is the total cost of ownership and total value of ownership. Once you have decided to sell the bike, what amount you have provided extra things. Okay. Then third one, it was program management. In the program management, three things are there, three ingredients are there. Those are people, priority, and project here. 3P, okay. P3 also you can say, or 3P here, which means project, people, priorities. Again, in this business priorities are there, vision and goal, then strategist and risk, multiple projects, dependencies, cost and value, business rules and infrastructure. And the last one of the business layer, it is what? Development. Here you are supposed to work completely about the data here. Ab jo bhi data collect karna chahte na, wo kahan pe dalne wale ho, how you are going to insert that data, what kind of a server you are going to use, how you are going to integrate all the data which you have collected from the different sources also here. Okay. So that was the business layer. Then second layer of your first business intelligence component framework here. Second layer, it is called as administration and operation layer here. Again, here also you have four categories are there. See, the way you had for the business layer, business value, business requirements, program management, and development. Similarly, here also, you are going to have four things. That is BI architecture. But before that, let me tell you that what it will specify administration and operation layer. Matlab, jo bhi aap business hai, wo kon handle karega, kaise karega, that is there here. And operation layer, how your business is going to get operated here. In your business layer, sirf decide karte jao. Sales decide karte jaane ka. In here, it is what actually you have to work. People ko hire karo or start working. Okay. So here, four things are there. That is the business intelligence architecture. Then business intelligence and data warehouse operations, data resource administration, and business application here. So have a look for your first layer of administration and operation layer. BI architecture. Two things are there. Very, very easiest is it. Five things are there, step by step and meeting. In your BI architecture, what all things will come? Check. Data is there, integration is there, information, technology, and organization. Have a look and let me know. Step by step. Take your time. Can anyone try for this? What is the data? All the information I have given. And what is the integration? Can anyone try for this? Anyone? Who all are there today? Natasha? Very easiest it is. Okay. In your administration and operation layer, you are supposed to work, start working actually. In your business layer, you have only decided. Sirf aapne decide kiya hai. Kaam karna baki hai. So here it is what your first layer, sub layer of administration, it is what architecture. Architecture means what? Construction. How you are going to manage your data, your technology, your organization, information, how you are going to gather. So for the data, where you are supposed to provide here, in architecture, kaisa karna chahte? When you are going to insert the data, you are supposed to follow the design standards. Now in your normal DBMS, how to create the table? You are used to say, create table followed by the table name, open parenthesis, and your variable name and data type, okay? So here also, when you're going to insert the data, follow the standard design standards. If you're working in DBM and SQL, please learn the syntax here. If you're going to work for your normal Excel sheet, according to that, you are supposed to follow here. You must have logically apt data model here. Logical apt data model means what? Atomicity should be there. If you have created once structure here, data should get automatically for the next time also. Metadata should be of high standard. Metadata means what? Data of data here. Meaning should be there for that respective data here. So whatever the data you are going to give, it's that data should have a high level of meaning here. Okay. Integration. Integration means what? Performed. Integration means what? First, collect all those data or collect all the different parts and make in one single part here. So perform according to the business semantics and rules here. Means what here, according to business semantics and rules here, how you are going to integrate that should follow the rule here. Rules means what? Normal rules. You are supposed to ensure that whatever the data you have collected, it is completely error free. Okay, so that is one rule here. Then second part, it is what processing standards have to be followed here. When you are actually, you are going to insert the data here, processing, what the procedure is there. You are supposed to start the database, provide that here, then off the database. This all will come here. And the last one, it is what data must be consistent here. Data should be always consistent. It should not be of low level here. If you're going according to from slow to higher, it should go on higher and higher level here. Then two things are over. Third one, it is what information here. So information derived from the data that has been integrated should be usable and findable as per the requirements here. So whatever the data you have collected previously here, here that data should have a respective meaning and it should be usable in your future. Wherever you have stored that, it should be acceptable or it should be useful here. It should not be completely idle. Then findable as per the requirements. What if we have stored that data, if you are about to search that, immediately the response should be there. So that is the information here, meaning dena padega aapko. And then technology here. What is the technology, the kind of technology people are going to use to collect data or maintaining your architecture of business intelligence. Technology used for deriving information must be accessible here. Everyone should have the authority to access your data here. Whatever the data you have created in your business here, that should be accessible. Assume that if you have created a website for the JioMart, it doesn't mean that I have to, it should make the visible only for Sanjana or Chetan Desai. For everyone, it should be accessible here. Should have a good interface, of course. Jo bhi aap create karna chahte ho website wagere, that should have a perfect interface here. Should support the analysis, decision making, data and storage management here. Analysis means what? Go and search deeply. Decision making means what? Comparison should be there here. And data and storage management also it is required. Then last one is what? Organization here. Consists of different roles and responsibilities like management, development, support, and usage roles here. This is completely of operation layer here. What it specifies, you know? Now, together people will work. Okay, so every people has a different kind of a role. Natasha will handle designing part, Sanjana will handle the coding part, and Chetan will also handle a main designing part of the website. Here. So for everyone, we are going to give the responsibilities, management, how they have to manage, and development support, how the development can be done, and what support they want here from the organization, and what are the usage roles here. Okay. So in your BI architecture, here 4-5 things are there. One, it is data integration, information technology, and organization here. Then second, it is what of your administration and operation layer, BI and data warehouse operations here. In your business intelligence and data warehouse operations, what all you can do here. In your data warehouse, think about the data warehouse here. So here, the data warehouse administration requires the usage of various tools to monitor the performance of the data warehouse, perform administrative tasks here. Means whatever the data is getting collected, no? So someone should be there to monitor that data here, whether the data is getting collected properly or no. Is it following the standards or no? Following the business rules or no here? What kind of a data they are collecting and where they are inserting and how the integration is being done, that should be taken care by the data warehouse administrations here. And they are supposed to perform the different tasks also here. So some of the tools to collect all the data here, what all tools are there? The main part is what? First one, backup and restore. Of course, why backup is required? Sometimes what happened, data warehouse data also will get crashed. Chances are not there, but we should be careful. Risk-free should be there. Yeah? So that time, someone should be there to monitor their data and always have a backup and restore here. And of course, the second one, it is what? Security. Yes, to access the data, the security should be there here. Authorized person should be there here. And the third one, it is what? Configuration management. You will say, no, configuration, matlab normal data kaise store ho jayega, kitna FB ho jayega, kitna GB ho jayega, kitna data aaj aayega. This is what the configuration management here. And accessible also should be there here. And the last one, it is what? Database management system here. Whatever the data of different sources are there, that is getting stored in one common database management system here. So this is your second sub layer of administration and operation layer, which is called as a BI and data warehouse operation. Two sub layers we have completed. One, it is a BI architecture. Under that, we have learned data integration, information technology, and organization. The second one, we have started completed the BI and data warehouse operation. Under this, again, four categories are there where you have to take care of backup and restore here, security, then configuration management and database management system. Okay. And the third one, it is what? Data resource administration here. Again, here two categories are there. Again, in the two categories, subcategories are followed here. I think today it is sufficient for me. Not well, kind of. So please start giving the attendance.